Hello and welcome to Java9s.com. This is Srinivas. In this session, I'm going to talk about the enumerations in Java. So before diving into the concepts of Java, let me give a short introduction about enumerations. Enumerations were introduced in Java in Java 1.5 version, and enumerations are declared pretty similar to a class or interface. I can say that the enum is a kind of concept which has the features from both interface and class. And the primary motto of enums was to define constants that are used in the programs. But remember that enums are much more powerful than that. And we'll see what are its features shortly. And then the most important part of declaring the enums was to enforce the type safety when using the constants. I'll explain you this with an example how type safety is very important and how enum can help in achieving that. And to understand the importance of enums, we should know how the need of enums has come into picture. Take any project, we have some constants in the project that does not change. We generally put these constants in an interface as all the fields in an interface are static and final, so that they are not actually, you cannot change the values of them. For example, if you consider this interface, which has constants defined in it, you can easily understand that there are two groups of constants in an interface. One is related to age, the other one is related to the cost with respect to age. Now, you can see that both the groups are actually defined in one particular interface. Basically, here, all the constants in this interface are actually integers, so we call this particular interface as int enum pattern. So if you start using these constants into a program, you can see that I'm trying to compare the age, which is an integer, with this age constant. There's always a good possibility that somebody can use this particular constant in this place. That means the compiler or virtual machine does not really check what type of constant he's using, but it will only care if an integer is used in that place. So this leads to misuse of constants, or there's no enforcing about which constant to be really used for the comparison here. So this was one of the drawbacks. And the other point is that sometime you might want to iterate through all the constants you have and would like to pick the values of them. With this particular interface, it is not possible to iterate through the constants and get those values. It is possible when you use reflection package, but it is again more complex concept. So these are the problems which is related to int enum pattern, and there might be string constants as well in a project. Something like this, where I have declared all the strings here. We generally used to do this because every time you can avoid declaring the string, and you can use this constant instead of this particular string. Now, the problem with the string constants is that most of the time you use these constants in terms of condition to compare if the particular mode is accepted, or a particular flag. You use these things as a flag. So here, when you use string, the comparison of string literals is performance intensive. So remember that when there are strings involved, there is also a problem, there's also an impact on performance parameter. And the next problem was that relating the values with the constant. Now you can see that this is a kind of Chinese menu where you have all the items as constants here, but we don't have a provision to declare the prices of these items in this interface. So this is one of the problem that you cannot relate any other thing to the constants here. This was one of the issues with the string enum patterns. So to solve all these issues, enums were declared in Java 1.5, and actually they are more powerful than enums that are there in programming language like C++. So let us dig into more details of enum, and first we'll see how an enum can be declared. An enum declaration is pretty straightforward. You use enum keyword and you declare the name and you declare the constants here. The example is something like this. I have declared the Chinese menu with the items here. So it's pretty simple and straightforward, isn't it? This is a simple way of using an enum, but enum could be more powerful if you would like to do more things. So we will see how enum can be useful in your real-time projects. So how do you actually get the constants from an enum? So all you do is just use the Chinese menu soup chicken, just like we call static fields is the same way you call constants from enum. That means you should understand that these constants are actually static and final. So that's the reason why we are able to call the values or constants with a class name or enum name. So I have already told that enums are already present in C++, but it was only introduced in Java 1.5. But enums in Java 1.5 are far more powerful and flexible when you compare with the other enums in other programming languages. So let me give you a better example of how enum could be useful, or enum can solve our problems. As we discussed earlier, I told you that there was no provision to provide some values to those constants. Enum gives you a chance to declare some values for your own, for your constants. You can see that I have declared some integer values inside the parentheses. And you should also note something here, which is a constructor. So remember that whenever I invoke an enum, the value that is present here will be sent to this constructor and will be set into this value. That means any of the variable you actually declare. So the important point you have to note here is that if you declare a constructor in enum, it has to be private. So without, if you don't declare it as private, the compiler is going to throw an error, So when you declare a constructor as private, that means you cannot instantiate enum objects using new keyword. Whenever you use new, obviously it will look for a constructor which can help to create objects, but here there's no chance because this constructor is no more visible. So with this point, you should also implicitly understand that there's only one way to create objects with enum is to use static factories. We'll discuss about that. And the next point is about all the constants declared in enums are static and final implicitly. You should identify, or you should be able to observe that I have used a comma to differentiate between the constant, and after final constant I have used as a colon here, so the semicolon here. So remember that all the constants here are marked as static and final implicitly. So this is a one single statement up to here. You should remember that. And we'll see about how enums objects are created. As I told you that this particular statement cannot be used to create objects of enums. Now we'll dig more in more details into how enum objects behave. So how do, as I told you, you cannot use new operator, new keyword to create objects. Then how do we create objects of enums? I told you that when you use this statement, actually what you get is not a string literal or a constant. You're really getting is an object of Chinese menu type, which has the constant name in it, which cannot be changed. Remember, the name inside this object is final. You cannot change that, but the values associated with this particular item can be changed by the programs. Only thing that is constant is the name of this object. So you can generally assign this particular object to any Chinese menu type. Like I have created a new reference called soup, and I have assigned the soup chicken object to this particular one. And I have already told you an object of type Chinese menu has a name, soup chicken. Now let us see what are the methods that are available in an enum by default. If you look at the Java doc, Java documentation, you can see that we have equals, we have finalize, we have hash code, toString, compare to, clone. These methods give a hint that actually enum extends object. That means an enum is actually declared as a class. I'll give you more elaborate explanation on this. For now, we have, apart from these methods, we have two more important methods that have to be discussed, and those methods are not part of the Java documentation. They are values method, which will return an array of enum type of objects. So this is generated by the compiler to return an array of enumeration objects. So let us see in detail about what values method is going to do. So basically, I have this Chinese menu enum class defined, and now I want to iterate through all the constants to get their prices. Now I have already discussed here that there was no provision earlier when you use interfaces to iterate through the constants to get those values, but with enums it is possible with the values method. So when I use values method, something like this, so you should remember that values is actually a static class. So then again, this returns an array of type Chinese menu. So whatever the type it is, it will return that one, and you can iterate through the objects and get the price of each and every Chinese item. If you have a get method for this value, obviously you will be able to retrieve the value and print it out. So these are values gives the array of enumerated types. And if you see in detail, remember that the values actually gives you six different objects here for this Chinese menu class, and each and every object is a singleton for a constant. Remember that for a soup chicken, this is a singleton object. That means you call it by Chinese menu dot soup chicken, you will get the same object as values will return. So remember, all the objects that are returned by values are always singleton. You will get the same object every time. So it's like, you know, internally it is having a singleton factory pattern. And there's another method which is generated by the compiler, is valueOf string, which accepts a string. So this particular method accepts a string and creates an enum object for you. If you know what is the name of the constant, and you if you pass it as a string, you will get that particular object. So this is generated by the compiler. And remember, if you pass a string which is not part of an enum class, then you will get an irregular or it could be an illegal argument exception. I'm wrong here. So it's take it as illegal argument exception. And there's another method called name, which is already part of the Java documentation. It will return what is the constant name. So returns the name of the constant in string. So if you use soup underscore chicken object, it will return the string as a soup underscore chicken. So the constant name will be returned for you. You can always use a two string method to get the same output, because sometimes you might be implementing the two string in a better way for your enum. You can always override it. And the next one is about ordinal. As I told you that the enum class can return the constants as an array, you might also think of getting the index of a particular constant, in what level the constant has been defined. So the ordinal gives you the index of constant which starts from 0. So you'll get 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, something like that. And the next part is you should take a look at the Java documentation, how enum has been declared. You can see that this is declared as an abstract class. Remember, this is a class. That's why we extend object here. So enum is actually declared as a class, and it implements comparable and serializable. Because this enum class is actually serializable, this is very effective in terms of using it for a constant class, which can help immediately serialize the objects and transport the objects on an on a network, and it can be easily deserialized. And the next part is using comparable. We have a method, compare method, which will help us to compare two enums if they have the same values inside them. So it will help us. And how type safety is actually achieved with enums? Let us take an example here. I have an age limit enum for which I am declaring two constants here, and I have age specified, and I am taking the age in the constructor, and I am setting the age here. And I do have another enum which has a ticket ranges for these ages, and I am having this getTicketCost method, which will return the ticket cost for a particular constant. Now, in a program, I have to decide what is the age of a person, and I have to return what is the ticket cost for him. Now, in this method, I'm trying to get the age limit from age limit, which is of type enum type, and I'm passing this age limit to the switch case, and I'm trying to get the ticket cost from this enum. So remember, you can use a constant, enum constant, inside a switch case. That's the best thing enums offer here, that you can directly use switch case instead of if else conditions, and it is more faster here. So remember, it is not a string here. You have to use the constant here. When you use the age limit enum here, object here, you should use one of its constants in the cases. So that is important here. So if you use some other constant from enum ticket cost range, it is not going to execute. So it is important. So this is how actually, you know, enums enforce type safety, that only age limit type of constants are allowed inside this, and you always have a type safety, which Java is very strict in implementing the type safety. So I told you enum can be used with switch statements. Only enum constants are allowed in case statements in which switch enum can be used. There are some more rules you have to remember about enumeration. Remember, enums cannot be subclassed. That is very important. You cannot create another enum and you say extends of so-and-so enum. Enum can implement interfaces because interfaces does not have any methods. You can always implement your own methods. As you have already seen, I have implemented a get method. In the same way, you can implement interfaces and you can override those methods in your enum. Well and good, but you cannot extend a concrete class. Remember that you cannot extend a concrete class. So enums cannot extend classes. All objects written by enums are singletons. Normal methods and variables can be declared just as we do in a class. That's why I have told you that enums are like a combination of interface and class, which gives you the power of both. And only a private constructor can be declared. And the values we assign to the constants are not final and can be changed. As I told you, only constant names are final, but not the values. That means any program, if you offer a set value or set price method kind of methods, you can even set the values for those things. It is possible to change the values. And advantages of enum. So enums enforce type safety. These are a few things you would like to remember for your interview purposes. Enums help in declaring constants and also values related to them. They allow to declare methods and to be invoked as a normal class. Enables to compare two enums using compare, and they are easy to serialize. And the big advantage is that you can use equals method to compare two enums, or you can directly use equals operator to compare two enumerations. And enum led to implementation of classes like specialized classes like enum set and enum map. You can refer to these two collection types, which are actually very good ones. And enums can be effectively used in switch statements. So that's one thing. So let us see some demonstration about enumerations. So just like I've shown you, I have declared a Chinese menu here with some values inside it. And I do have get price method and set value method as well. So let me just display these using the values method. So if I'm going to execute this one, I have the values getting displayed here. I have the constant name of the each and every object is getting displayed, and the value as well. And the next thing you can declare is, I told you, there's a valueOf method as well, Chinese menu. I'm talking about just to create an object, then Chinese menu dot valueOf string, and this time I'm just passing a string which is very similar to the name of the constant. So this should be there. I have told you that this particular string should exist. And now let us print what is the name that is inside the soup. So soup dot name. So here I'm printing the name. So we'll see how this gets executed. You can see that the constant name is getting printed. That means it has returned the object. If I change this string, and now because this constant is not there in the enum, it has to throw an illegal argument exception. Yes, this is throwing an illegal argument exception. So that's how you have to use this. And let us see something about ordinal. So here you can get from an object, you can get even the ordinal as well. So let me just print the ordinal. So here Chinese menu dot ordinal. So we'll get what is the position of each and every string object that is returned for us. Basically, I'm doing it in a loop, but you don't have to. Even if you print it with any object, it would tell at what index it is. You can see that ordinal is 5. It is starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, something like that. And the last method was, I think, these are the methods that we have. Let me check the PowerPoint. Yeah, type safety, enum, name, ordinal, that's all. These are the important methods that we have to take care of. Other than that, equals, you have finalized, all those methods are there in the object class. So you can explore those methods. And with regards to age limit and ticket cost range method to implement the type safety, you can see that I have implemented the same method to get the ticket cost. So if I remove these comments, it should execute this method and bring out and execute this switch statement. So what is the age limit I'm passing? Age limit I'm passing is minor max. So let us see what it prints. So minor ticket cost is 17. So minus ticket cost is 17 here. So it is picking up the age and it is printing this for us. So I'll upload this example as well in the java9s.com website. So for your reference, you can take a look and execute it yourself, and you can explore more things about enum. So then that's all for this session. Thank you. And you can download the PDF of this presentation for your reference from java9s.com. I'll update the link in the YouTube description part. You can like my page on facebook.com/java9s to follow my updates on the sessions. You can follow me on Twitter at java9s. Please subscribe to my channel java9s to get more updates on my tutorials. Give your feedback as comment, and thank you. Have a nice day. See you.